I know you can't wear it yet, but I thought you should see it. Do you like it?
Oh, it's beautiful. Mrs. M, do you think I...
I think you should see if it fits.
Oh, allow me.
When do you go?
Next week. But when I leave Wentworth tonight, that's it. I won't be coming back. I'm sorry.
Why? You're not to blame for everything that's happened to me. You just gave me time to get myself together, that's all.
By trying to protect you, I damn near destroyed you.
I'm not destroyed. I'm ready to fight them now.
Barges. You, Mum.
Love you too.
Your precious friends may have won this round, lady, but I'm still here, and I'll make them pay dearly for all the hurt they've caused. Because now I've got nothing to lose.
Try to get a rhythm going. It's important for exercises to be smooth, especially when you're warming up.
Hey, Nance, are you sure Maxwell wasn't bullying you?
Oh, I don't think so. She seemed very bitter.
Yeah, that's because she hasn't got a screw looking after her no more.
Hey, do you reckon she'll do anything?
Well, she wouldn't dare eat a drop kicker if she did.
Shouldn't be talking, ladies. Bad for the diet.
Get out, girls. Have a bit of muscle on you, eh?
Oh, look at the hunk. Oh, come on, you two. Just find somewhere to sit and join in choir.
Not exactly a nine-stone weakling, are you, gorgeous?
I manage. We're doing some warm-up exercises.
Oh, you mean what you're doing? I'm sorry, Mrs. Morris. Being stuck in the pan does funny things to you.
Well, you go right back in there if there's any more nonsense.
Okay, let's try some opposite toes touching. Legs straight, feet apart.
This is boring. When are we going to get stabbed on the weights and stuff?
When you get warmed up. You'll pull a muscle if you try it now.
Now, come on, just do what Tony says.
Okay, take your timing from me. And left, right.
Jean Moran's been transferred? Right. You're joking, Nat. And they've dropped all the charges against me for lying into Bassinger.
Nothing
good on Jess, eh? She really fixed it up.
Right. I'm warning you two.
Right. I thought this was going to be fun.
Beats counting bricks.
Gee, he's gorgeous.
G'day.
Thought you'd be in the gym with the others.
Nah, rather work. Helps keep me here to the ground doing this. Hear all sorts of things.
I'm sure.
Helpful for you. Stay one step ahead of them if you know what they're planning.
I don't need help from anyone. Especially not you.
I don't blame you for being upset. I would too if I had just lost my boyfriend.
You just shut up about that.
Connors and Jenkins just got out of the pound. They're after you, you know.
I didn't lag on them.
Doesn't matter. They're smelling blood. Yours. Of course, you don't have to take them on single-handed if you don't want it. Be surprised at how many of the girls are saying Connors is losing it. We organise them together and bingo. It's Connors out in the cold, not us.
Forget it.
Now, in a bit closer, Joyce, so I can get you both into frame. That's it. Look at him. Bit of a smile. You too, Merv.
But my clothes. These are my work clothes. If I'd known you're going to take some more shots, I would have got changed.
I'm going for this warts and all. Documentary style, you know. Read a book about it last night.
Yes, Uncle Percy, but we are supposed to be on duty.
And you're still making us pose.
Got to give the audience what they want. That's it. Now, look. Slap an arm around her shoulder, Merv. That's the idea. And make it more natural, you see. Relax a bit, Merv. You're stiff as a board. That's it. Oh, that's lovely. Now, big smile, both of you. Oh, that's beautiful. What a perfect footnote for the wedding.
Thank goodness it's Joan Ferguson's afternoon off.
Oh, great. Now, if the officer can vacate the chair, we'll go for an action shot.
Oh, die, I'm awfully sorry.
Joyce Pringle on the job at Wentworth Detention Centre.
Yeah.
Oh, what a finish.
Oh,
One of them things that male models use for chest exercises.
Yeah. Careful with that. You could strain a muscle.
Hey, yeah. One of those new ones I got in warm-up, eh?
We'll just stick to weights today.
Yeah.
How's it going over here?
Oh, Nancy's doing much better than me.
That's great, Nancy. Well, let's have a look at your technique.
Well, I'm all right. I can bring it up like that, but then it just gets too heavy.
Sorry.
Oh, God, I didn't mean to drop it.
It's all right. No harm done. Try it again, eh?
How about a bit of skipping practice? See if you can go the fastest.
Oh, you're probably school champ or something.
You chicken or what?
Yeah.
Who wants to have a go?
Oh, I'm sure it's not what Tony had in mind.
All right, let's get these mats
clear. What's this about? Man shooting through. Ooh.
Yes, it's true. We're not happy about it.
Yeah, well, if you see him again, tell him rotten luck. If you hadn't done that to Maxwell, he'd still be here.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Blame us.
It serves him right for getting mixed up with a stupid bitch like her.
Hey, Rick, you going to be in the competition or what?
Yeah, sure.
One, two...
Three,
go.
Good on you,
for a moment there.
Oh, it can still be arranged. Your place or mine.
All right, ladies, all right. Time to pack up. Now put everything back where you found it.
Oh, can't we have a few more minutes? I've got to get to training.
You
heard
me. Lexie, you'll overdo it.
Do the baby more harm than good.
Is there any of them that won't?
Well, they really seem to enjoy it.
They're not the only ones. Is it okay if I give this to one of them?
Sure.
Nancy, this is for you. You did very well. Showed up some of the younger ones.
Oh, hey. Wow!
Afraid not.
So we're going to end up looking like...
I'm sticking to skipping.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Brownie. It's lovely.
Hello. Look, he's coming out of the closet.
Well, I've enjoyed myself, girls. Hope you did too.
All right, ladies, move.
I'd like a bit more of a squeeze.
Later, after I put it up.
Guess who we're going to visit after tea, Lurch?
Oh, yeah. Keep him warm for us, thanks.
Oh, mad, that lot. Come on, you can fill me in a bit on what's been happening.
Yeah.
Just forget about her. She tries anything, there'll be a dozen warriors racing each other for a piece of her, including me.
I'm not sure that's the right way to go about it.
Listen, about that poster, I was wondering if you'd like to stick it up somewhere where you could...
Bloody hell!
Who could have done it?
Whoever it is has got...
What were you saying about Maxwell wanting to get back at himself?
Well, it could have been someone else.
Come on, help me clean this up, and then we'll go and visit them.
Fuck! Oh, I'm terribly sorry. I did. Well, hello. How nice to see you again.
Likewise. Joan, this is Mary Harris. Albert Ross, Joan Ferguson.
Pleased to meet you.
You remember? I was telling you about that character in the pub was going on about women's golf.
Yeah.
Well, Joan, she was the one that went wallop and sent him right off.
Well done. And I suppose he bored you silly with his golfing stories as a reward, did he?
Well, not really. No, he was partly responsible for me dusting off the old clubs and having another go at it. But not very well, I'm afraid.
Well, it'll take you a couple of rounds to get your swing going, you know. I tell you what, do you feel like joining us? Make the numbers up.
Yes, we're one short.
Oh, no, I'd only hold you up.
Look, the only thing that'll hold us up is this man deciding whether a green slope's left or right.
Dear, dearie me. Look, why don't we start again from the 10th?
Fine.
Yes, suits me. I was three strokes behind anyway.
What do you say?
Well, yes, I'd love to. Thank you. There's just one thing, though. I don't suppose you saw where that ball went.
bitch. I ought to break both her bloody legs.
Where do you think I should put this?
Who cares? I'm going to have a chat with Maxwell. I'm going to thump that bitch for it, whether you like it or not.
I don't like it.
Oh, shut up, Nance.
Look, it doesn't do any harm to talk to her, and if it works, we'd have solved the situation without violence, and if not...
Okay, anything to get you off me back.
Thank you. Well, I suppose now's as good a time as any.
Yeah. After you.
Kath, we'd like to talk to you.
Really? What do you want from me this time? Another admission of guilt?
I'll bust your face.
Rita!
We wanted our dorm redecorated. We would have done it ourselves.
I didn't touch anybody.
Oh, sure you didn't. You just stopped by for a cup.
Let her go, Rita.
We don't appreciate rats like you taking our dorm apart.
Didn't touch it.
Oh, you can't expect us to believe that.
That's what you want, isn't it? Me admitting to everything that goes on here.
Only what you do yourself,
which is getting to be more in your fair share lately.
There are 25 others in this damn block. I don't suppose it occurred to you that one of them might have done it.
They didn't make the same threats that you did.
And they know what I do to house wreckers.
For your own good, you've got to stop being so vindictive.
Persecution seems to be the word you all understand.
Look, I told you time and time again about lagging, and Julie lost her parole because you wouldn't listen.
You were critical as the rest of them. Worse! God, you killed your own husband in cold blood.
No! Oh!
Been a closed fist if it was me.
Get out.
You'll keep.
How's it going, Ray?
Oh, rat old worm.
Hey, what gives? Don't tell me
I
that.
I want to be left alone, please.
Sure. You know where to find me if you change your mind. About giving them a taste of their own medicine?
So, if you'd like to tell the others, we'll start the show right after dinner. Everything's set up, ready to go in the rec room.
Oh, good on you, Merv. Could do with a bit of a laugh, eh?
Lex, she's wedding.
Well, can I see you in it, Mrs. Morris?
I dread to think.
Did you get any of the reception film, Mervyn?
Believe me, nothing was missed. See you all there. Thank you, Mrs. Morris.
Hey, who's supplying the popcorn?
Eat your tea, Patterson.
Hey, come on, Nance. You've got to get that strong right arm of yours in condition.
Well, that's nothing I'm proud of.
Oh, good on you, I reckon.
Lexie?
Hey, Nance. Heard what you've done to Maxwell. Good one.
I'm beginning to wish I hadn't.
Oh, come on, Nance. You only gave the bitch what she deserved.
Oh, I know.
Hey, might add me own little bit just so she doesn't think we're finished.
Oh, watch where you're going, you stupid oaf.
Who are you calling an oaf, you clumsy bitch?
Yeah, what's going on?
She dropped her dinner, Mrs. Zem. Wasn't watching where she was going.
Can I go, please?
Not before you clean up this mess. Jenkins, get your meal and sit down, will you? You can get a second, sir, once you've cleaned it up.
I'd rather go without.
Suit yourself. Just make sure you've cleaned this up before you do.
Bad luck.
Yeah, but a well-played hole, though, Joan.
It's a tricky green, this one.
Well,
this will make the third par in a row, Joan. That's really good.
You're very lucky to be able to play during the week.
Yeah, it's like Burke Street here on the weekends.
What exactly do you do to get afternoons off, I mean? Oh, well, I...
She's a lady of leisure.
Oh. How lucky. You must join us more often.
Well, thank you. I'd like to.
Quiet in the gallery.
Oh,
yes. Certainly, Mr. Nicklaus, sir. Albert, it gets dark about 8:30, you know.
I'm not the only one.
You brought it on yourself.
This time,
you're gonna pay.
I don't know what you've got in that number three wood, Joan, but that shot on the 10th was terrific.
Oh, it was a fluke, believe me.
No, you can't kid us. Not after that bunker shot at the 15th.
I've seen so many players come to grief there, you know.
Including me last week.
Oh, yeah. Come on, I was still 10 over, hardly up to your standard.
A few more games, you'll be playing in the state championship.
Oh, competition I can do without.
Yeah, well, I couldn't agree with you more. Anyway, here's to the greatest sociable game ever invented by man, eh?
Cheers.
Well, now I'll be off. I've got to go and feed the roses.
Oh, yes, I'd better go too. Lovely meeting you, Joan. I look forward to our next game.
Same here. Bye, Andrew.
Yeah, bye.
Well, I'll have to make a move soon too.
Oh, it's getting on, I suppose. I've teed up a game with a few other friends tomorrow. I'd love to have you along if you feel like another round.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm on late shift tomorrow.
I thought you said that you didn't...
I'm sorry. I wasn't quite honest with you. I do work in a prison. I'm the deputy governor there.
Oh, I see. Well, that sounds a pretty responsible job.
Well, it's not very glamorous, but it involves a lot of shift work, so I get time for the golf.
Yes, well, if we only did things for glamour, none of the important work would ever get done, would it? Joan, I didn't mean to pry. If you don't want to talk about it...
No, it's all right. It's just that there's a lot of stress involved, and, I prefer to leave that where it belongs, in the workplace.
Yeah, well, I know what you mean. Mind you, if you start getting too many more pars, I might use it as a tactical weapon to throw your game.
listen, about tomorrow, I just might be able to juggle the rosters and get some time off.
Yeah? Mm. That's splendid. Then I'll consider it confirmed, shall I?
Right.
We're going to have to give you some lessons in how to get along with people, right, girl?
Yeah!
Try your own advice. You haven't left me alone since I got here.
Should have thought about that before you killed your kid. Maybe we could use your head for the next volleyball match, eh?
Screw! Check you later.
Well, ladies, suppose we better get started. What's going on in here?
Oh, I hate to tell you this, but your tape's stuffed.
What happened?
Maybe it came loose in the bag or something.
Oh, someone destroyed it on purpose. Who was it? Do you know anything about this, Maxwell?
We'll get the one who did it, promise you.
Don't be silly, Connors. You and Jenkins have been in enough trouble lately.
Is there another copy available, Mervyn?
Probably. But how do I know another won't be treated in the same way?
Because I'm guaranteeing it.
You wouldn't stop all of us from seeing it because of one person, would you?
Look, it won't happen again, honest.
Yeah, we promise, Merv.
Come on, Merv. We'll see if we can get another copy by tonight.
Thanks, Mrs. Barry.
What's Mrs. Pringle, you mad?
Still using the screws to protect herself.
Don't worry, it's going to be a different story, Joan. What do you think you're doing, slime?
Nothing. Just hanging around like the rest of you.
Yeah, well, get your stink out of here.
Sure, Rick.
During the what?
I hope you haven't got your heart set on the video, Lurch. Because we're going to be missing most of it.
No, they don't want to see a tape of Pauline's 21st. I'm trying to explain the tape. Uncle Purse, please, the tape was ruined. I'd just like to borrow a copy, if that's all right.
It's the last of them.
I'll get a cab over straight away.
Well, he's working on it. Oh, I'll be calling in to see Dan later.
How is he?
Out of bed at last.
Yeah, the women.
That reminds me, the police called. Still no leads on Bongo Connors.
Well, he's probably gone interstate.
And apparently his girlfriend Roach has gone missing as well. Yeah. Inspector Barrett thinks he's still here, keeping out of sight.
Well, with any luck, she could lead them right to him.
The sooner the better.
Yes, I think so.
Well, it's all organised. He's bringing one over.
Great.
Oh, do you think Joyce is right about Maxwell?
Possibly. It doesn't seem her style, though.
There's always someone who ruins it for the rest, isn't there?
You'll let us know when the show starts, won't you?
As soon as the tape arrives. And this time I won't be letting it out of my hands.
Good idea. Though I don't think the culprit would dare to try it again.
Oh, I thought you were showing the video earlier.
We had a slight technical problem.
All right, Miss Ferguson. It's not compulsory.
All the same, I wouldn't mind popping in for a look later on, if that's all right.
Of course.
It'll make a pleasant change from all the death and destruction we usually see on the television. Governor, look, I might not have very much to do later on. I'll take over those maintenance reports, if you like.
Thank you.
Well.
And here I am waiting for Mrs. Pringle to come down the aisle.
Jeez, you look a bit nervous, Merv.
Everyone's nervous when they get married, Lexie.
That's an understatement.
That's a beaut outfit, Mrs. P.
Yeah, what op shop did you say you got it at?
Oh, here's the minister reading the vows. You can just see Mrs. Morris and Mrs. Reynolds on the side.
Well, I knew I shouldn't have come.
Not since you look lovely.
Oh, I wish I'd really been there. It's not the same on the small screen.
Oh, dear. How did that get there?
Oh, don't tell us we're going to miss the good bit, Merv.
Oh, we're going to see you pronounce husband and wife.
Oh, what's happening, Mervyn?
I don't know.
Oh, beauty, Merv.
Grab her, Lurch.
Leave me alone.
You're coming with us.
Getting what's coming to you, kid killer.
Okay, come on.
No!
Oh, look, there's Steve.
Dynamite, I do.
Any screws around? No. Ferguson must have gone up there and looked at the video. I want to get back before anyone finds it. Hey, you know how to work that thing?
Has the Harley got two wheels?
Take this as your last warning, Maxwell. The next time we'll get serious.
First, wouldn't let us finish the night without a shot of us all in together.
Where are you, Mrs. M?
I had to leave early. Bit much champagne?
Oh, you party pooper!
That's all?
Oh. Uncle Percy would have had us filming for the next week if we'd let him.
He did a wonderful job.
Hey, this is great. We could make our own movies if we had one of these.
Be careful, Patterson. You don't want to damage someone else's property.
It's worth a lot of money, Lexie.
The department wouldn't consider lending us one of those, would they? Lexie's right. It'd be a terrific activity for everyone.
Yeah.
And we could make, you know, tapes to send to people on the outside. Jess would be stoked to get one.
Who does? I'm sure it's a terrific idea, but it's Mr.
Where have you two been?
It's very expensive.
Oh, Lurch is feeling a bit quick.
Yeah, I'm scared I might faint or something. Hope there hasn't been any trouble, because if there has, I'll certainly know where to look.
Yeah, but what if we got one in ourselves?
How can we afford one?
Oh, I don't know. There are wise. What do you reckon? They come at that?
Possibly. I'd have to get full details of where you intend getting it from.
Yeah, no worries, eh? Hear that, right? We're going in the movie business.
Yeah.
Oh, it just so happens I know a leading lady out looking for work.
Let's not jump the gun, shall we? I want to call into maternity on the way back. Night, ladies.
Night, guys.
Don't forget to thank Mr. and Mrs. Pringle for bringing the video in.
Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Pringle.
Hey, we could, you know, film our stand Ollie routine. We'd make a bloody fortune.
Oh, no. Oh, boy, I was nervous enough doing it in front of the screws.
Officers.
You okay?
Oh, thank God. Hurry up.
Better be quick. Screw Sia, though. No, did you wreck that tape easy?
Just hurry.
Who did it? Collins and Jenkins? Bloody lasted a lot of us for giving the
Come
chance.
On, what I need is a shower. Some of this stuff.
Right.
Smashed your stupid head. What'd you get of stuff?
Well, I scrounged some canned stuff. I saw your mate Screwball. I asked him to help out.
Screwball? You've been shacking up with him all day.
Jeez, Bong, fair go. I couldn't come straight back here. The cops were after me. I had to cruise around for the arvo, make out like I was looking for a new place to live.
Yeah, well, you should have nicked some money from that old bag before you left the flats. Could have had something decent to eat.
Look, I'm not nicking nothing from Edie. She's been really good to me.
Yeah, all right, I heard all before.
Thank you.
You stupid bitch, there's no can opener. Now I'm going to open this without a bloody can opener.
I've got one here. And it's the last food I'm getting you unless you stop having a go at me.
Sorry, lover. Just can't act being holed up in this dump all day, you know.
Yeah. Well, we'll be heading off soon, won't we?
Not we. Me. It's too slow with two of us. Look, it'll be all right. I'll come back for you as soon as the heat's off, okay?
Why did you have to go and do it in the first place, Bong? Dan was your mate. You buggered everything.
Dan's not a conqueror. He stopped being a conqueror the day he started laying that bloody Reynolds bitch. Ask Grubb and Shafty, they'll tell you.
Yeah, but running him down...
Well, just forget it, will you? It's too bloody late now anyway. The best thing I can do is put as many miles between me and this dump as quick as I can.
Just because we came in late doesn't mean we did it.
Of course not. Could have been anyone, couldn't it? Pity they were all in the rec room watching the video.
Oh, but I was feeling crook. I still am.
Well, you need something to take your mind off it, don't you? You've got 10 minutes.
I'll be spent.
10 minutes. Phone fights. A bit puerile even for you, Connors.
Actually, I was thinking of inviting you to an official competition, seeing as how we beat you at the volleyball. Everything under control, Miss Ferguson?
Yes, Governor. These two are just about to clean up their mess.
How did it happen? Well, we thought there was this fire. We didn't want to disturb everyone watching.
Another word, Connors, and you'll find yourself in solitary.
Seems this sort of thing runs in your family. All good, clean fun until someone gets hurt. If you're talking about Bong... I'm talking about you. You've been in far too much trouble lately. Unless I see an improvement, you'll earn yourself a visit from the VJ. Is that understood?
Whatever you say.
Exactly. Mrs. Morris?
Get on with it.
Lucky Maxwell got away. Otherwise, we'd really been in it.
It would have been worth it.
Yeah.
Stop the chatter.
Tomorrow.
Yeah. Well, I can't hang around here any longer. You said yourself the cops are tailing you.
Yeah, but I won't be seeing you for months. Look, can't you hang it off for a couple of days?
No! Gonna need some money, too. Queensland's a long ride. Petrol's gonna cost heaps.
Look, I told you, I'm not pinching nothing from Eddie.
Well, I don't care where we get it, just get it!
None of my friends have got any.
What about I?
Ida? You gotta be kidding. She can't hardly rub 2 cents together.
Don't you believe her? She's still got a heap from that stuff we shifted into REIT. Couldn't have spent it yet, nothing to spend it on.
All right. I'll ask her.
You do that. And I'll tell her I'll give it back to her when I get a job.
What are you gonna do up there?
I don't know. Cane cutting? Peanut farmer, something will come up.
They won't stop looking for you, you know.
Yeah, I know. I'll head over to Western Australia. Well, I reckon they can't trace you in those big mines over there.
Look, you can always give yourself up.
Are you crazy or something?
Well, at least you'd still be around. The cops will go easy on
you. The cops don't go easy on bikies.
Not if you give yourself
up. Look, just shut up, will you? Go and see Ide. Well, go on.
See you, lover.
Don't mean the end of us. It's just until things cool off, okay?
Hey, Maxwell, move it, will you? You haven't said boo since we've been here.
I've been thinking about Connors, what you said about combining forces.
Yeah?
You're right. There's no point trying to take her on alone. She's got too much support. But if we can pull that support out from under her...
Now you're talking.
With the women on our side, Connors will never treat us like dirt again.
You can't expect Jess to buy a camera for us.
Why not? She'd be in it like a rocket.
Heard what Mervyn said. They're very expensive.
Yeah, maybe we should just all save up for
on $1.60 a day.
Well, we'll have to think of something.
could be a good way of coping with the boredom.
Yeah, well, our bag's been directed.
Oh, what would you know about directing?
Oh, it's easy. All you do is say, lights, camera, action. Hey, we could do one of them serials, you know? All dress up as rich bitches, having to get the old man's empire.
Well, we're a bit daggy looking for rich people.
Yeah. I was thinking more of a chat type show, like they have on the lunchtime.
Yeah. Oh, they're boring.
No, they're not. One of us could be the host and we could interview the others.
Discuss current issues.
Yeah, like there's a rumour going around that the freak's really King Kong after he's had a shave. Would you care to comment, Miss Egbert?
No, I was thinking of serious interviews. And then afterwards we could do a documentary on life inside.
Oh, look, he's angling to be director now.
Well, we should just wait till we get a camera.
How'd it go?
Yeah, what the freak want?
Oh, she wanted us to clean up the mess we made after giving Maxwell a body shampoo.
Yeah, with the fire extinguisher.
You're joking!
For wrecking the tape, but I
thought... For everything. For lagging, for pulling the dorm apart, for not waking up to herself.
Oh, yeah, should have seen her.
Do the screws know what happened?
All they know is Lurch and me emptied a fire extinguisher.
But the further we persecute her, the more we alienate.
Oh, sing another song, will you, Nance? Now, come on, tell us all about the royal wedding.
Yeah,
oh,
hey, what happened after you saw the minister?
Oh, no. You saw a dress, didn't
yeah.
you?
Yeah.
I can't wait that long. It has to be now, before she thinks of some other way of getting at me.
Calm down. We stick together, we'll be okay.
If they see us together, they'll have more reason than ever to play tough.
Not while I got this, they won't. My insurance policy protects two just as easy as one.
Do they know you've got that?
Will do, the minute they try something. Here, get a feel of it.
No, thanks.
Sit yourself. Got it from a Sheila in C block. Wasn't cheap. If you want support, you've got to pay for it. Fact of life.
You want money? Is that it?
Can't do much without it. You must have a bit tucked away for a rainy day.
Assuming I have, how do you intend to use it?
Buy more of these, of course. And a bit of muscle. Enough to show the others that we're serious about doing Connors.
And how do I know you won't take the money and just leave me high and dry?
Because I want Connors off my back just as much as you do. Geez, I don't enjoy carrying a knife around with me just so as I'll know I'll make it to my next breakfast. But it's better than having Connors use you as a bloody doormat 24 hours a day.
Are you sure the money'll do it?
Haven't seen anyone knock it back yet.
I'll ring my husband tonight. We'll have it by tomorrow morning.
Keep your eye on the road there, dearie.
Yeah, well, it's all right for you. You didn't spend half the night hassling money for Bongo.
The cheek of that bloody fella thinking I could lend him some, you know. I spent night on getting my vehicle back on the road. Nice little job, isn't it, eh? That's as reliable as the day she was made. Now, when you're going to stick up a milk bar here, you've got to do it nice and early because them people are bleary-eyed, you see. They'll never know what hit them. Hey, looks bloody real, don't it?
Bloody hell, I'd have put it away. Someone will see it.
Don't forget to take it when you go in.
This is bloody stupid. Don't you know anyone else who could lend us the dough?
Yeah, the only one who would have. Danny boy.
Maybe you could ask Bongo to, you know, stop. We could go back there on the way.
No way, not my problem, dear. Mind you, I'll tip the young bugger up for what he done. But you can't question your fellow when he makes up his mind to do something. Now, would you like me to drive so you'll get there all relaxed, eh?
No, look, I'm right. What's going on? I thought you said this car was reliable.
Don't worry, no, dear. Only gets a bit excited.
Oh, God.
I couldn't shut her up. She kept coming up with ideas for this video club of hers in the middle of the bloody night.
Well, if we do want Jackie to help, we could have some ideas to put forward.
Hey, I got one.
Hey, everyone, Lois has got an idea.
Oh, no. Hey, you know, what's his name? You know, the bloke that showed us how to use the weight. Well, we could film him, you know, working out, getting all sweaty and everything.
Oh, calm down, Lurch. Come on, Jules, take it. Hey, no, turn on the cold water.
No, we can't go in and see him. What's your deal?
Oh,
get a move on, will you? And stop fooling around. Stop you buggers.
Hey, Nance, I've got an idea for a film. Attack of the Green Slime with Williams playing the slime.
I hope you being with her is an accident, Lexie. We're going to write to hang around with whoever we like.
Or has that changed too?
You're getting a bit ahead of yourself, Worm.
Yeah, we still owe you.
A bit late, aren't you? Middle one's free, Pat.
Just rack off! Jules was here before you!
Oh, it doesn't matter.
Bullet doesn't! Are we going to drag her out or what?
That was a bad move, sister.
Bloody hell!
I regretted striking her the moment it happened. I'd allowed myself to succumb to the philosophy of so many women here, an eye for an eye. I'm also afraid I've contributed to Kath Maxwell becoming more bitter. It all came to a head last night as we were watching the videotape of Mervyn and Joyce's wedding. Rita and Alice tied her to a security gate and covered her with foam from a fire extinguisher. Fortunately, Kath got away before the officers discovered her. Alice and Rita were caught out by Miss Ferguson for spraying the foam, but it was assumed they were just having some harmless fun. I don't condone what happened, but I hope it means the last of this sort of thing.
And you've got evidence to support this claim of yours?
Nothing I can show you, but the fact is it happened.
The fact is you come in here throwing around accusations without any proof whatsoever. If one of the prisoners did that, you'd want them thrown out of the office.
My source is reliable.
Oh, yes, this source of yours. Perhaps it's time you told me who it is. We are supposed to be a team, after all.
What's really important is that Jenkins and Connors are dealt with. They belong in Blackmore.
Which is not taking transferees until further notice.
Then we have to get tough with them.
On what pretext? This unsubstantiated source of yours? Honestly, Miss Ferguson, you can't...
Governor, if you refuse to take the advice of your deputy, then I have no option but to report you higher up.
Don't you ever presume to tell me how to run this prison. And frankly, I don't think the department would be too happy to hear about the risk you're running, using a prisoner as an informant.
Your words, not mine.
Rest assured, your name will feature prominently if the women find out about this lager and mete out their own punishment.
Well, then get Maxwell in here. She's bound to cave in if enough pressure's applied.
And guarantee the woman a further bashing? Obviously, you've decided not to listen. Thank you, Miss Ferguson. That'll be all.
Oh, I can't see the minister being too pleased with your lack of team spirit.
You're talking insubordination.
Am I?
What did I tell you? As soon as someone stands up to him, they fall apart.
I wouldn't get too cocky.
You saw it for yourself. Connor's chickened out and the others could hardly raise a dirty look between them. Believes her own publicity, that's her trouble. Hey, you still owe McCormick one, don't you? Biddy's getting too big for her boots.
I'm not interested in her or the others. I want Connor's.
You can't just sit around and let them make bloody fools of us.
All they did was grab a spare shower. It happens all the time.
Oh, great, Chook. So what are we going to do? Let him get away with it?
It doesn't matter.
Well, Kath wouldn't be planning anything. Not after what happened last night.
Don't believe that.
Well, serves her right if her only friend is Williams.
Williams set me up in case you're forgetting it. I say we give them both a bloody bash.
And I say put a sock in it. The trouble with you is you're always dishing out the cure before you know what's wrong.
That's true, Lex.
Oh, thanks for backing me up, Chook.
Well, Kath's in virtual Coventry as it is. Any more, you'll just provoke her.
If she gets half an inch out of line, she's gone.
Oh, by the way, I got another idea about the video.
Gordon uncovered a Cecil B. DeMille.
I got the idea from something Lexie said last night.
Well, what do you know? Somebody actually listens to me.
Steve and Julie could send videos of each other backwards and forwards instead of letters.
That's a great idea.
Get right up the freak's nose. Serve her right for not letting him visit. Yeah.
Hey, do you reckon Mrs. Reynolds would agree?
Every chance.
Hey, you could spread him around, you know, give us all a squeeze.
Alice, I was thinking of something a little more private.
Something tells me Lurch is going to need a cold shower.
Thank you.
Oh, if you're looking for me this afternoon, Governor, I won't be here. I'll just swap shifts with Mrs. Pringle.
Fine. Just make sure you don't leave before 10. The minister's making a special trip out at my request.
Oh, and what's the occasion?
A discussion of your attempts to undermine my running of the prison.
Well, it saves me the effort of writing a report, doesn't it?
And colouring his attitude with half-truths and omissions. Make sure you're there. I want this matter cleared up once and for all.
I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Screws hanging around?
Been and gone. How did you go?
It's all happening. Got some real little beauties.
Well, they better be worth it.
What do you reckon, eh?
Is that all you got?
It's not a bloody supermarket, you know. You better have plans for getting the dough in fast. It took a real lot of talking to convince the Sheilas in B block that you were good for credit.
I've already rung my husband. He's bringing it in this afternoon.
Got him twisted around your little finger, eh?
Are you sure those women aren't going to tell Rita what's going on?
No, they won't get their dough if they do. We better stash this stuff fast before somebody springs us.
In here?
Nah, in Reno's bloody office. Where else? What's wrong with you, Maxwell? One minute you can't get your mitts on hardware quick enough, and the next you're acting as if it's got the plague.
It's all right. It's just getting used to having it around, that's all.
You better be game enough to stick one of these in Connor's ribs, because if she figures you're not, she's going to pull you apart.
Well, I'll put this over here.
What are you, nuts? Anyone could find it there. Got to use a bit of nous. Look, I'll show you. Hey, Maxwell, I thought you'd like to...
What's this? A pig-sticking convention.
Just showing her the ropes. Just in case the hoons in C block hassle us.
I assure you.
What we do is none of your business. Get out.
You're getting to be a number one on the agenda, kid killer. Especially now you're waving one of them around.
Left me no choice.
I was on my way to tell you we decided to give you a week in Coventry and leave it at that. Now, how about you hand that thing over before you hoot yourself?
No!
Bitch!
I don't want to.
So help me, I'll kill the next person who lays a finger on me!
I'm already on one murder charge. I'm quite willing to wear another if I'm forced to. Anyone can talk big with one of them in their hands. I'll be seeing you.
Jeez.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun.